Hi guys, welcome back. In this one, we will be porting a flash loan trade bot from the Polygon chain, which is where I had it, onto BSC. All right, quick reminder, if you guys do want something like this or any other web project done, email down below, reach out to me, and me and my team will get it done for you. Yeah, but in this one, this will be probably a really quick video. This is a continuation from another video, so if you haven't seen that video yet, you can go check that out, where I explain everything that I'm doing pretty much. But basically, we'll just be taking a flash loan bot that I created previously, and I walk you guys through how to set that up in the previous video, and I'll be converting it to BSC chain. It was having some problems, so I'm hoping to get it onto BSC. I was hoping to get it onto BSC chain so that we can start developing. I'll cover it in the previous video. In this one, I'll just I was having some problems getting it to compile and launch on Remix. All right, so in this one, this video is pretty much just dedicated to getting that thing on the Binance Smart Chain, right? And then maybe getting it up and working, and then in other videos we'll continue to develop it. All right, so I may not be talking quite so much in this video because I know there are problems coming up. I'll be saving all my energy just to to debug whatever issues come up. I'll be explaining stuff where I think there is maybe need for explanation, but that's pretty much what we'll be doing in this channel. We'll just be porting a flash loan trade bot. All right, yeah, and without further ado, I'll just jump right into it. Pay no attention to this, starkly drawing here. I just really needed the light for this whiteboard here with other whiteboards and stuff, in the other videos. So if you haven't seen that yet, you can go check it out. But you can just jump in right here with me, and as I'm putting it on Remix. So hopefully this can be a very quick video, because I'm really just trying to get to launch. The only thing that I can foresee making this a super long video is if it just refuses to work, or does this thing not have a white theme? This probably would be very good for lighting here. Terrible for my eyes, but the lighting. There we go, super toxic. All right. So I have to do. So this should be a possibility for a super quick video, if I can immediately get this thing to compile, because that's really all I'll be doing in this video. Then in other videos we'll be going over see if we can get to do a flash swap. So stay tuned. But yeah, all right, so where was I think I changed, don't do that, I think I changed some of these. I want to change this to the BSC version now, of all these tokens. I think I changed them to Ethereum last time, and then I was having shit. I think I even said this should also work on Ethereum. There's no reason why it shouldn't, so I probably misquoted myself last video. But BSC for now, because I know there should be something. All right, so I want to change those, then hit compile, then yeah, we'll see. We just open up this code here just to make sure we have it. We don't need this specifically right now. Yeah, we don't need this specifically right now. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to BSC scan. All right, I'm gonna grab the address for all these tokens so I can get them in, and these tokens kind of just help me. I'm in the wrong place. These tokens just exist in the contract to facilitate liquidity, if you will, right? They're not super, you can put them in any order. They're just there to facilitate liquidity for or flash swap. Terrible explainer, but I dive more into the video. So first thing I want is I want WBNB. I save myself a click by just copying the address. Probably do more than that. Last time we were having some weird issue here, like, so it's giving some crazy stuff. Oh no, alright, so. Alright, so I want to kind of go in order of where I expect liquidity to be, so I'm going to change this back to WBNB. WBNB. Oh crap. I'm going to change this to WEAF. Alright, just because I expect more liquidity to be on obviously WBNB than WEAF and the BNB Smart Chain. Right? Me wondering why my Bluetooth keyboard suddenly decided to disconnect. Okay. Not a Taptonic token on the Binance Smart Chain. Okay, then we replace it. Interesting. Okay, like I said, these are all kind of swappable. I just need them for liquidity. Volume. This like BUSD which got discontinued. I'm very curious. Is that another one? Okay. Interesting. A BUSDT. Yeah. I know BUSD like. It says it's 24 volume, 24 over. Ah, here's BETH. It just wasn't ETH. Okay. I'm gonna go off volume. It doesn't matter. Like I said, they kind of just used to facilitate swaps, right? So what I mean, can I save myself the extra click? Probably can. Why I'm bothering to click through is because I know sometimes there are capitalizations there and that can cause issues in Remix. So for example, if I do BNB. Don't really care. It's no bother. What's its name? BUSDT. You see? Just probably it's complaining because sometimes the capitalization matters in the in solidity, I should say. So so I bother like getting it from here. It really gives it to me in the BSC or SDC. I was doing this off like volume, but then like it kind of hit me like if the price is high then it will be off volume, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's trading a lot. Which, why do I care about that? Liquidity, my friends, liquidity. All right, so I was gonna then do holders, but then you know, then that's also can be a misleading metric. For example, this is kind of discontinued, right? But as you can see, has like a lot of holders, probably vacant addresses. So I'm just gonna go off intuition of what I know is everywhere, basically. So this is just what I should have done from the get-go. But it's interesting to know. SDC, Miku, wasting time. SDC, WEF, or EF. Just this guy. Alright, so I'm just getting the tokens I know there's the liquidity for. Ideally, probably want to put it in order, so. USDC probably go here because I think it's second in terms of what is liquid here. I also want USDT because I know that's liquid. You cannot leave that out, right? For me anyways. Actually, I don't know why USDT gets so much hate, right? Like it's well, I know why they get so much shit, because it's kind of shady as hell, but, you know, they've, it's probably it, right? Looking at USDT and, like, the whole time, and, like, not knowing it's because it's named weird, right? Alright, so we do BNB, USDT, USDC, with this is fine for me. Alright, it's probably actually how we had it before. Alright, alright, good to go. Can we compile? Alright, perfect. Now, what I want to know is can we launch? Do we even have enough tokens? I bet we don't. God damn it. Alright. Average maybe. I'm trying not to like try not to have to do too many steps here. Once you have to do too many steps, doomed. Icy, and the the time once you have to do too much work. God damn. Ugh. I'm gonna say a motherfucker. This isn't. Come on now. You receive ETH. I don't want to receive ETH. Bruh. Can you even swap? You have to do all this. You gotta do. Alright, since it's a, we are too poor for the, we are too poor for this bridge. Alright, let me see. Bridge. Let's try pancake. Let's see what's up. I think I've ever done a bridge before, now that I think about it, which is extremely interesting. How comes? Eesh. I think I've just always done exchanges. ETH is not available on BNB chain. What? Hey, what did you say? Network. It's cool because I'm not trying to get ETH. Polygon maybe. Oh, we don't have it added. Wait. I don't think I have something there, so we will probably have to initiate some type of a send from our exchange. I was hoping I could just do a bridge room, like, god damn. Let me know. I want to know how much. Let's find out how much this even costs. Let us find out. Top of the charts, back in the hearts. Last time, you see there now, why couldn't it just work this nicely on like Ethereum, bro? What the f- okay, all right, now we have to send some BNB. So all right, this was all this what's up. Goddamn, bro, and like we have like just enough, like come on bridge, let's see. Bridge from ETH to BSC. Okay, all right, right, so it wants you to do some fancy shit. Is it worth it? It's probably not worth it, to be honest. Yeah, because then I'd have to swap probably to get the stable coin. It's not worth it. All right, I just send let's send a bit there, so we have it in our wallet to transact. I'm underestimating. This is gonna be a few steps. Top of the charts, back in the huts. Yeah, alright, this is what we have to do. Alright, so to get some crypto. Alright guys, so if you're still here, you know, we're getting some just getting some crypto. Have to get it on the exchange, get it on MetaMask or MetaMask, then to on-chain. Yeah. Come on. Having to do a lot of P2P trails, press is taking forever. God, they can be such a pain in the ass sometimes. Imagine me trying to make this video really short, this scripted trailer taking forever to answer me. Alright, we can probably do this another way. Yeah. This person's taking too long. was hoping I wouldn't match me with the same person. He literally matched me with the same person. Just not online right now or whatever. Have to pay some extra fee, right, to make this go quick. I ain't got time for this. Is this from the app? Oh, for fuck's sakes. Yeah, it is not. I swear for like the for the time you take in, you think this fucking up is Fort Knox, right? And I swear to God, they're really not. You would think for all these protections that they have, they actually do like a great job, but like they really don't. So annoying. Think for all the fucking that they do. Why are you telling me that it's like Adi, but at the same time, like when I see the UI, I cannot. Bro, like, guys, you see like the bullshit like that you have to go through, like, so wild to me, bro. The bullshit that you have to like go through before I've even like begun. It's crazy, bro. Crazy. Alright, bro, alright, that is wild, bro, like, okay. It's just congratulations, man. You have sufficiently pissed me off. Crazy. Crazy, 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 crazy. Really not Fort Knox, right? So dumb. Dude, am I being trolled? What? Didn't I just click this thing and it was okay? I don't care. I do not care. Doesn't matter. I say to Stu, I suggested this to Binance bro, create a pin that like creates an extra layer of security. Like they have this and that, like what if your device gets hacked, you're just screwed, right? Like this, oh god, it's a fucking disaster, bro. Fucking finally, bro. Like, Jesus, bro. Like, now we wait. Okay, so I can mark this in the video so that I can know, like, when to, create timestamp for you guys. We're just waiting, but God, fuck, that took forever. Jesus Christ. Hate that shit. I think it's registering here, I think. It says it has, so anyways, I want to try but I don't want to look around and find out. It says it's still processing. Rather than wait, I'm gonna just assume that it's like worth. Alright, so yes, did we have everything checked? Alright, let me. I probably can save us some time here. Let me hit the 9999 compile. Alright, inject the provider, blah blah blah. Make sure we got the right contract. You see, this is the shit that we mean, you know. I hit the right one, you change it back. Why you gotta change it back? Okay, alright, so I'm brave, risking it. Why field? So I'm guessing Remix bugged out, right? So it does that. Alright, so alright, back to this. Alright, duration 9999. Injected. Alright. Guys, this video could have been done. Like, okay, you guys will have the magic of YouTube, but just know that we could have hit this stage like half an hour ago. Alright, confirm. Why you do me like that, bro? Why, like, what is happening? Creation of contract and error for me. Transaction underpriced. Bro, that ain't my fault. What the heck? Unless I change some settings in Remix a while back. Okay, let's try this again. Perfect. All right. Jabber contract created. All right, now I'm just gonna verify it real quick, all in one go. Then we can let's see what else we can do. So file on my mama bird at the Tulang. All right, hit this. Optimization is cool. This, I'm not a robot, of course, but I feel like a robot whenever I have to do any of these things. Okay, now just verify. Okay, no bullshit. Perfect. Okay, I know we can like read our contract, we can see all our addresses that we put in. So what's this? So all right guys, that's launching the contract. Now this, with this thing launched, we should be able to make calls to the blockchain. All right, what else I want to do? All right, so let's look back at our code. Let's look back at our code here that will be handling some of this stuff. All right, thing that I have to do is I have to swap some configs. I have to change out I have to change out some of these as well as other stuff. All right guys, I mean, just thinking if I want to let's call this like one vid and make it at here. Alright guys, I'm gonna do this real quick, so maybe we can see if we can get in one video. So next video, we can get to what we really want to get to, which is some further research and stuff. Alright, so once we have our contract launch here, I don't want to lose this, so I will copy this address here just plop it in a notepad real quick. You wanna be as organized as you can. Okay, then I am going to you're also gonna need some tokens in your whatever account you are trying to interact with, right? So I'm gonna send what do I want to do here? I'm going to transfer some between these accounts. Actually, I'm going to send to me too much. What am I doing? Why am I doing this? Stuck making a decision where it doesn't really matter too much, I guess. Alright, yeah, you know, I'm sending it to this one here. Alright, why am I doing this? Doing it because we're gonna need a little bit of, like, even though we're doing flash swaps, right? You don't need your wallet to you don't need any Boy, we just found some crypto. Boy, we been rich. How comes we didn't know? Should have made a mask. You know, but yeah. Even though we don't need any crypto to do our flash swaps. Our flash swaps are atomic and free, right? Like, you still, when you're doing the transaction, you're gonna need maybe a bit of transaction fee. So that's why I did that. I transferred it right now because I want that in a specific wallet, because we are going to have to plop our private key here somewhere, kind of like this. All right and I wanted to I'm sure you like all these, like, yeah, I wanted to do it from that one. All right so I all right so we'll take care of that in a second. But never mind that, guys. You just want to make sure you have, like, maybe a very little amount, could be like $1 or something, I think, depending on whatever transaction fees are on the blockchain, right? And bear in mind that, like, with flash loans, you may be competing for time, so you probably want to be a little bit competitive. So right now it's $1, you can get a cent, you can get a transaction off, so, you know, take that for what you will. But so you need at least that, I guess, in the wallet to pull off the transaction. If it goes through, it doesn't cost you anything if it doesn't, right? Yeah, all right, so back to this here. All right, so the next thing we want is, I wanna, let me duplicate this thing and call it BNB, or BSC, I should say. BSC, right? I want to take my contract address here, put it here. All right. Then I had some exchanges here. So if you guys remember, this video is already long, bro. Like, if you guys remember, I did a little drawing here, kind of like explaining, how triangular arbitrages go, right? So you have asset one here, you can say you have USDT, all right? And this is one, this is USDT. Okay, right? Here you have BNB. All right, here you have I don't know, CRV. And then to here you is, so you go from USDC to BNB to CRV and then back to USDT, right? And you hope that the profit is here, all right, or somewhere in the middle here, right? That's kind of the general idea. But also I still haven't found my other whiteboard, right? You can also do cross exchanges, right? You have bank one, you have bank two, right? You have and these are separate liquidity pools, right? These are separate pools of liquidity. You can have also swaps happening here. So you may have BNB cost $2 here, and you may have BNB costing $3 here, and then you can it also takes advantage of, okay, maybe you can get BNB from exchange one and, you know, sell on exchange two and collect the profit. Okay, all right, ignore all the terrible drawing, guys. I will do my best to timestamp, and as well as I did an explanation in the first video, you can go check that out. But yeah, that's kind of, that's what's happening here. So I'm like gonna get you know, this is exchange one, exchange two. I'm just gonna get me exchange and exchange one and exchange two. In this case we can use PancakeSwap, all right, and this code is optimized for v2, so I'm gonna get PancakeSwap, SushiSwap maybe, and something else. QuickSwap I think is still good. So I'm gonna do, alright, so I want, and again we're gonna stay a bit organized. It's not all the time taking like sending that over. Out the window, that me, how long is this video? It's too long, right? But in any case, all right, so we need factory and router. All right, cool. Let me see, sushi. Just in the Google wisdom of Google here, because to be honest, I am hella tired, right? But also, you can see here the transactions popping off, which is a good sign, pretty frequently. So, that's a good look, all right. And we because I don't want to actually change any other code or be mad lazy here, I'm just gonna like, can I comment? No. Oh no, this is JSON. All right, it burns. All right. For this, you could rename them, but if you rename them, you also have to rename them here, which is. Okay, bro. Okay, all right. God damn it. Pancake. QuickSwap. It's QuickSwap. Pancake, QuickSwap, SushiSwap, whatever. that. So let's have that here. I tired myself one. No, I don't remember shit. It should be just a copy paste. Is that it? Feel I'm just gonna have to go revisit sometime. It should work if I just put USDT. All right, I'm a bit fucking annoyed, to be honest. Primarily because self-explanatory, you kind of want to just make sure you have the right addresses there. Okay, which we luckily don't have to dig too deep into because we already have them here. Alright. So we have that filled. All right, so once we have those variables filled in, I'm just gonna make sure we are reading also the proper config, and I'm just gonna borrow just up here. You see. Right, and you're going to need the network address. Sorry, but it's so crazy to me. Like, I can't believe I spend that much like mental energy. Like, just it's like which crypto can be like so ass sometimes. But because I swear to God, I'm not tired from like looking at code or anything. It's I should have probably split these in like a couple of minutes, but if you guys want me to redo this with like a shorter explanation, you can just reach out to me, or I'll maybe do that myself in another video. But you can get this from chainlist.org, right? You can go BNB, should be able to see some addresses here. All right, let's just go with this one. But you do want to meet. You can test different one of different ones here. It's just it's just what it needs to connect to the network. Okie dokie. All right. All right. I want to make sure that I put this here. Let me just copy this real quick. Worthy to be SE, I guess, if you will. All right. Okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie. Wait, what is this? I plop so many things in this fucking. Yeah, no, it's all good. Hey, yeah, it's all good. All right, this should be enough to get this running. We just need one more thing, which is to put our private key here, which is where our transfer came from earlier. So I will copy this, put it here. All right, and you can see I create a file. Can just create the file. We can see also in the previous video, right? And I will 1 second, magic of YouTube. All right, resuming magic of YouTube. All right, guys, and so that what I did there, I just put my key, my private key there for the account that will be used to connect into the network. All right, and you guys can see how to do that in MetaMask by going to account details, show private key, will prompt you to enter your details, and then you'll be able to see that. Obviously, we don't show that on stream / on video, but all right, with that, now we should let me just close this real quick. All right, to make sure. All right, with that, now we should be able to get this thing running. All right, I hope. All right, if I remember correctly, this should be something like I don't remember. Let me see if it's anywhere. Yeah, I should. You guys can see I was messing with AI. We do npx hard at run, bsc scripts, blah blah blah, true, blah blah blah, 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 blah. Right, and I forgot to install some stuff, trying to use a non-install non-local Java, which is not supported, so I guess I have to do npm install first. So I forgot that in the directory. All right, guys, and if you miss some of these, don't be afraid to like ask me questions down in the comments, as well as I will probably do another video going over this in more simple terms, maybe, hopefully, you know. If it's in high demand, you know, then like I'll do something, you know. Email me, find out. You know, all right, so that should be that. Now we should be able to do that, I guess. I hope, right? It says we called the wrong file, true. That's right, it's just true, right? Blah 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 blah. Blah. All right. I think this is actually working right now. It's actually doesn't say so, but it's actually checking for tree. It's let me go this real quick so you guys can see. It's telling me execution reverted. So real quick, let me just see. did. It's actually because it's coming here. See this in more detail. This checking. So it's running this loop here, which is. Oh, we forgot our boys here to get the proper one, so we'll do that. So you have to get the right addresses, so we'll do crazy, we Google it too. We have pancake router B2BSCS. Alright, we wanna copy that. Right, put that in router right there. You want a factory, which you should be able to get from here. Right, should be from there. Sushi. Good enough for me. Got a mount there. That's row there. Row there, factory. Contact factory. Should be able to get from here. Alright, let's see if we get something different. Well, I probably didn't want to, it's probably executed on. Alright, so, alright, so yeah, as you can see, it's kind of right now, it's checking. For arbitrages and seeing if there is something profitable. I will go more into detail about this in the next video, where I'll be doing like a lot of research to kind of and I know the code is working properly, but I want to make sure we're doing it the best way to get actual arbitrages and that there is nothing wrong and stuff like that. So, but right now it is checking, so I would probably leave it for a little while to see if it finds anything. The code here is pretty much the same as I have it packed, you know, in the previous video. I don't think I changed anything that deep. I can probably, there's one thing I changed, it was probably that, which was probably a mistake, to be honest, right? It will do the same thing, right? So I should already have that, right? Okay, well, maybe I want to copy this out then, so it can determine. This line basically just says you determine the cost for this transaction, right? But as you can see here, it is actually checking. I don't believe it's charged me any yet, but if it does find something, right, it will flash swap for us and do something profitable. So in the next video, we'll actually be doing like a lot of research around that, but not right now. We accomplished our mission, regardless of how long it took us to just send some coins to the network here. We accomplished our mission of bridging this onto the Binance Smart Chain, and in the next video, I will be diving more in depth into the strategies at play here and all the more technicalities, so that we can give ourselves a better shot of you know, getting our arbitrage off, and not just do the small arbitrages that we managed to do in the past. All right, guys, but if you do like these videos like these, leave a like, leave a comment. You know, if you do want something like this done, or any other web project, email down below, reach out to me. Me and my guys will get it done for you. But until then, I will see you guys in the next one. And I hope your bot finds profitable trades for you. I'll leave this running for a while, and then put it up on a server or something, so we can turn off our computer, because we don't want to leave our computers running the whole time. Maybe I'll show some of that in the next vid. All right, guys, so I'll see you then in the next one.